So now students, look at the degree of comparison. As I have already taught you that what is degree of comparison? Comparison between the adjectives is called degree of comparison. So now look at the examples. Raju is tall. A, this is a positive degree. B, Aman is taller than Raju. So taller. Okay, this is comparative because Aman is compared to Raju. And the last sentence, Rahul is the tallest of the three. And tallest is the superlative degree because among the three, Rahul is the tallest. Okay, so tall, taller, tallest. What they are? They are positive, comparative and superlative. Okay, so what is a positive degree? An adjective is said to be the positive degree when there is no comparison. Children, when there is no comparison, like Roy is a strong boy. So strong is an adjective. It is in bold letters, highlighted words. But Roy is not compared to anybody. And see B1, Rita is a generous girl. Okay. So what kind of girl Rita is? Rita is generous. Already adjective of Rita is told that she is generous. But there is no comparison with any other girl. So it is positive degree. Now look at comparative degree. An adjective is said to be in the comparative degree when it is used to compare two nouns or pronouns. Okay. When there is a comparison, then it becomes comparative degree. Okay. So look at the examples. Roy is stronger than Ram. Okay. So Roy and Ram are compared. So strong becomes stronger and it is comparative degree because Ram and Roy are compared. B, Sneha is fitter than Mona because Sneha is fitter than Mona and Sneha and Mona are compared to each other. So it is comparative degree. And the last one, superlative degree. An adjective in the superlative degree when it is said to compare more than two nouns. That is, Raja is the strongest of the three boys. So there are more than two boys here. And Raja is the strongest of the three. So strongest is the superlative degree. And B1, he is the healthiest of them all. They are many. So, and what kind of boy? He is the healthiest of all the boys. So healthiest is the superlative degree. So now you might have understood that what is positive, comparative and superlative degree. Okay. So look at the table here. Look at the table here. Positive, comparative and superlative. Clever, cleverer, cleverest. Rich, richer, richest. Thick, thicker, thickest. Young, younger and youngest. So this is the comparison between positive and comparative and superlative. Okay. Now you might have understood that how you make it comparative by adding ER and how we make it superlative by adding EST. When there is comparison between two, it is comparative, and when it is comparison between two, between more than two, that is three or many, so then it becomes superlative, and when there is no comparison, it is positive. Identify the adjective. You have to identify the adjectives and also name the degree of comparison, whether it is positive, comparative or superlative. The first one has been done for you. That means one example is shown here. The young man was more successful than his friend. Young is adjective and it is a positive degree because there is no comparison. And more successful. Why successful? More successful is second because more stands for comparative degree. Okay. So now come to the second one. Jay is taller than Ravi. Taller, ER is added and it is a comparative degree because Jay is compared to Ravi. So taller, it is circular and it is comparative degree. Third, the longest lane is still closed for the public. Okay, longest, okay, long, longer, longest. Longest is the superlative degree. And it is closed for the public. Public stands for many, many, hundred, thousands and many. So The longest is still closed for the public. Longest is the superlative degree. Fourth one. The happy child played with others. So, what kind of child he was? He was happy. So, happy is the adjective here. And what kind of degree it is? Positive. Because there is no comparison. Okay? Fifth. Solomon was one of the wisest men. Okay? Children, you might be knowing wise, wiser, wisest. And wise is the positive degree, wiser is the comparative, and wisest is the superlative degree. And wisest, this adjective stands for Solomon. Solomon was one of the wisest men. And wisest is circular, and it is superlative degree. Okay? G's dog has become lazy. So, the behavior of the dog is told here and it is a positive degree. 7. Mr. Sharma is wealthier than Mr. Verma. So, Mr. Sharma is compared to Mr. Verma. And ER with wealthy, IER is at, and then that makes it comparative degree. It is comparative. Let me listen to the most important news of the day. Children, you might be knowing much more. Most is the superlative degree. So it is, most is the adjective told here. It is circuit and it is superlative degree. 9. During summer, Delhi is hotter than Kolkata. So Delhi and Kolkata are compared in the sentence. And during summer days, Delhi is hotter. So ER is added with hot. So it is a comparative degree because two cities are compared together. 10. May and June are the hottest months in North India. Okay. EST. It is added to make it superlative degree. And it is the adjective and it is superlative degree because they are the hottest month and it is superlative degree. Okay. Now come to the next exercise and that is J. Read the following sentences and tick the correct one. The first one has been done for you. Burj Khalifa is the most tallest building in the world. Okay? Burj Khalifa is the most tallest building in the world. Okay? It is told wrong here. Because why? Why? Because tallest. Tallest is already superlative degree. So there is no use of using most. Much more most. Although most is the superlative degree, but when we have written tallest, so what is the use of adding most with tallest? No use. So it is wrong. Okay. Now second one. Charlie is more kinder than Sana. This sentence is also told wrong here. Why it is wrong? Because kinder. So with kind ER is added and it is already comparative. So there is no use of more. So it is wrong. Third, Suresh is the most efficient person in the organization. Okay. So most is the superlative degree. And in an organization, there are 100,000s of people working. So Suresh is compared to most of the people, to many, 100,000 people. So it is still Suresh is the most efficient. Efficiency is adjective and most, that is superlative degree. So, it is correct. Suresh is the most efficient person in the organization. It is told right here. Rita is more shorter than Rashmi. Although, short is an adjective and ER is added to make it comparative. Here, students, Rita is compared to Rashmi. So, short becomes shorter because two girls, Rita and Rashmi, are compared. So, what is the use of more? No use. No use of adding more. And it is wrong. The last sentence, he is braver than his brother. So, he is compared to his brother. So, braver. It is a comparative degree. So, two persons are compared together. If two persons are compared, then what is? It is a comparative degree. So, this sentence is right. He is braver than his brother. It is told right here. Now, exercise K. Read the following passage and underline the adjective. Children, you might have known, you might have heard, or you might be knowing about Mother Teresa. She was one of the greatest social workers. Okay, she was one of the greatest social workers. She won Nobel Prize and she was appreciated, and she is remembered for her great social work all the world. Okay, so she was a great nun who devoted her life for the benevolence of poor and needy people. So there is a paragraph upon Mother Teresa. Now have a look here. Okay, Mother Teresa was a kind lady who served the sick and poor people. So you have to point out the adjective kind. It is the adjective. It is underlined here. Okay. So second, all the generous and humble people who wanted to help contributed willingly. Okay. So now look at the second sentence. All the generous. What kind of people? Generous and humble people. So it is underlined because generous and humble are adjective. Who wanted to help contributed willingly. So willingly is also adjective. She could not bear to see a hungry child or ailing person. What kind of child she can't bear to see? Hungry and ailing people she can't bear to see. So hungry and ailing are adjective told. So she could not bear to see a hungry child or an ailing person and was keen to serve them. Now there is a big home called the Missionaries of Charity in Kolkata. So big is the adjective here, where many people are taken care of. The underprivileged and the needy are looked after well. So which people are looked after well? Underprivileged and needy people. The people who work there get great satisfaction by doing so. Okay? What kind of satisfaction? Great. So great is the adjective told here. So children, you might have understood what is adjective and what is degree of comparison. So practice the exercises and learn a lot.